We're back with BJJ Weekly this week with our resident
permanent resident.
Yes, I hope so. I like this section, you know.
I love that. I love that, Pete. I love doing that, man. I have so much fun, you know. Let's talk about jiu-jitsu. What do we love?
Exactly.
It's awesome. Exactly. It's awesome. I love it.
Two things I love for sports: jiu-jitsu and lacrosse.
Your son is doing very well in lacrosse, huh? By the way, I watched that game. Wow.
Yeah, he's doing good.
That's awesome. Yeah, it's a future there. Did you play lacrosse, right?
I played lacrosse. I did.
You're good at that thing?
It's pretty good. Yeah, I was
pretty
good.
You didn't weigh that much, did you?
This much? Like 205? No.
Oh my God.
I was probably 205.
205?
Yeah.
So now it's 210, 215.
285. No, I'm down in the 250s. 250s.
250s. Our body, it's totally different. I'm 30 pounds lighter than you. I can move faster.
So. I'm 30 pounds lighter. Couple more weeks.
Okay, Pete, 250.
No, but jiu-jitsu, you know, seeing your kids train, both your kids train, man, how does that make you feel as a dad?
Oh, unbelievable. It's unbelievable. And I don't push them. I don't push them at all. It's unbelievable. It's unbelievable. I mean, see they go into your... Because, Pete, jiu-jitsu made me who I am, you know, and everything. Like, taught me, like, discipline, you know, self-confidence, and many other things. And I think watching my kids going through that, I think it's very important, you know.
Oh,
it's
yeah.
Because I help, you know, I help a lot of kids coming to my school with many different reasons. And, you know, I can see how much jiu-jitsu help them. And you can do that for your kids. That's awesome. But I don't push them at all. You know,
right.
I don't put any responsibility, nothing on their shoulders. Just come and have fun. Play
yeah.
with your friends. That's
yeah.
what I tell them. You're
going
to don't
play with
your
friends.
Don't get too serious
about
That's it.
That's
it. Not at all.
They're not going to lose
Let
interest if you're trying
Let
to.
Let them choose if
yeah.
they want to get serious.
Not like a boot camp.
No.
What I know you started young. Didn't you used to skip school or something? Your principal used to sign you out for jiu-jitsu?
Oh, Pete, you can't get me into these things, man. You can't get me to talk about these
Speaking
things.
Of kids and jiu-jitsu.
That's not a good, yeah. That's,
yeah, tell
that's
me that
not,
one.
That's not a good, ex-
that's a good
example
one.
For kids. No, no,
no.
So pretty much what happened is, it's a long story, but I'm going to make short. So,
Go ahead,
that's
spit
how crazy,
it out.
That's how crazy jiu-jitsu took my life over.
How old were you?
Man, I was 17, 16, maybe. So, pretty much like that. I wasn't going to school.
I was skipping, no. I wasn't going
to
school.
I wasn't going to school for a couple months. And, no, not a couple months. Let's put a month, a day, you know, a couple days, whatever. So, my father called the school one day, and they said, he's not here. I was like, what? He's like, he hasn't been here the past month. My father, what? What is this kid is? So he thought, you know, we used to have a summer house like right in front of the beach. I used to surf.
Oh, nice. High society.
No, not at all. So my father went right, like drove right to our home to see if I was on the beach, like surf or whatever.
Did he train?
No, my
no.
father,
oh, okay,
no,
okay,
nothing,
okay.
nothing. So my father goes there, didn't find me. And he starts like, oh, shit, where is he? So I don't know why. He's like, you know what? Let me stop by at the jiu-jitsu. So when he got there, I was there. He looked at me like so pissed. And so I'll make sure short. So he find out like that I was coming there every day. And he's like, man, how come you never got in trouble in the school? And then when he looks in the corner, the principal training with you.
So your principal must have been like,
my father's
oh,
like, oh,
shit.
Now I know how. But I was a good student. I mean, I was a good student. I was doing well. I was passing everything.
Class
you know?
Clown.
Yeah, I mean, I was a good student. I was a good student. So I was doing well. But when I hear the funniest thing that happened that day, my father always saw me when that age because I competed. Like I think I was a blue belt by then, maybe. My father always watched me like, you know, like chasing for sponsorships, for like... asking for people to help me to pay my tournaments, pay this, you know, pay whatever I had to do to compete.
Right.
That day, my father saw my dedication, how much I was dedicating myself to that thing. And my father sat down with me and he's like, listen, you don't need to chase any sponsorship anymore. You don't need to go anywhere and ask for anything. I'm going to sponsor you 100% for whatever you want.
That's nice.
But the problem is, I don't accept second place, just first.
Ooh.
But honestly,
that's a little pressure.
It was. But Pete, you know, I think that's why I'm here today. And because he supported me like 100%, 100%.
So what happened when you lost?
Oh, I was old already. He didn't give a shit. I cried like a baby. He cried it too. Yeah. And he was like, because, you know, after that, he's pretty much like.
Wait, you fought at all levels?
All levels.
Yeah. Did you lose? My whole life. When was the first time you lost?
My first time that I lost, it was a brown belt. I was for Zé Marcelo, a friend of mine. And I didn't lose from my blue, from my white through my until my brown belt. And I lost to Zé Marcelo, a friend of mine. But it was already like ahead. It was so ahead, you know, so ahead of the well, I was older already, so my father didn't bother. By that point, I had other sponsors or whatever. But he was like, I think that changed. But well, the point is this, is that's why I am today. That's why I'm here today. Because all the support that my parents gave to me after that, they saw how much I was dedicating myself to jiu-jitsu, and they're like, you know what? Let me help this kid. You know, let me give him a little push. You know, if that's what he wants to do to his life, as long as he'll be happy, let me help him.
Imagine if you had this resource back then. Holy shit.
Wow.
People don't get it, do they?
They don't get it. It was nothing. Nothing back then. Nothing. Like, I remember when the first magazine, like Tatami, I mean, from my time, probably before that was even worse, like came up. I remember, you know, it was like a newspaper type of thing.
Yeah.
You know, you pass the finger, your fingers are all dirty, black. All black. Yeah. I remember when that came up. It's crazy, Pete. It was nothing there. Like technique. All the techniques they stayed in the schools.
Inside, yeah, they didn't get shared.
No, nobody knew what it was. You had to wait for a tournament to see what was going on. And the pitch was like 3-4 tournaments a year.
Right.
A year. It was crazy. And remember, my blue belt was like, I used to compete like twice a year.
Right.
If you were lucky enough and you didn't get hurt.
Right.
Because if you got hurt, then you compete once and was crazy, crazy, crazy.
So I know we haven't left a lot of time for the actual technique.
Oh,
but
I'm sorry. Yeah,
good stuff.
Let's run.
What are we working on today?
I'm working a choke. It's actually this choke. It's not many, many details on it. It's a very simple choke from all four that you're gonna bring your hand on the semi side that you are, bring all the way and get your four fingers in. Your other hand goes right on top of the neck. And then what you pretty much do is you sneak your knee in, throw your leg over, and keep him tight on you and choke him. That's it. It's so simple. It's a very simple technique. It's not many details. I think it's very well for, you know, a beginner to advanced. It's a cool technique of fourth, like when you get those guys that they lock everything on the third position.
Right.
You just sneak. Do you know Little Jimmy?
Yes, your student.
You know. So
he's pretty little.
He's pretty little, right?
350 300 pounds.
Something. Oh my God, he's huge. He's like 6'5", 300 something pounds. But he loves this choke. He loves this choke. You know, and if you see a guy on his size that can fit this choke in that easy, works for everybody, in my opinion.
Wow.
So it's a very nice choke that you get, like you get your hand across, going all the way down, reaching the far collar, and remember, four fingers in, and the other hand goes right on top of the neck. And you fit the choke as you move. So as you sneak your knee inside of his belly, you fit the elbow in, the choke.
He can't pass your like, he can't go by your legs there.
It's hard because that's how the chokes get tighter. That's how get tight. If he try to keep moving, where my leg is, get tighter because I have his arm with me.
If you can't get your arm in, would you scrape his arm with your knee?
No. I need the arm. If you lose the arm, the choke is over. You lost the choke. So you need to keep his arm there. The most important of this choke is keeping his arm in.
Right.
As soon as he relieves the arm, the choke is over.
Okay. And tell me about the dynamics of what your that second hand is doing as far as, is it going across? Is it coming down?
It's coming. The hand gets right on his neck, right? Oh, see, you can work the sweep there too. It's funny. Just I thought I didn't record the sweep.
Oh.
Yeah, the sweep is in there because if your opponent pushes through, you sweep him to the other side. See, Brian's asking me now, like, Brian was asking me, hey, how can you defend that? And he's like, oh, if I jump this leg here, as soon as he jumped, got tighter. He's right. Like, oh, that's get tight. So I told him, Brian, want to see how defend? Come here again. I don't know, you know, if you keep that, you'll be cool. He moved the arm out. Yeah, and he's like, oh, it's no choke anymore.
Absolutely.
You know, it's just you need the arm so bad to keep this choke.
Just going to see a few details here.
So if you go, look, the hand on the back, you fit in right on his neck, and you get to move your wrist and make your wrist fit right pretty much in front of his shoulder with the movement. You go all the way, you get the four fingers inside, lock a nice grip, then you're going to shoot the knee in, fit, look at the elbow that I said, my forearm is going to get in, done.
And there's a finish. Down. You're not choking him with the back of your hand. You're choking him with the bones. The bones.
The elbows are closed. Yeah, the bones. There we go.
Awesome. Great That's technique.
A very cool choke, Pete. It's a very true, very simple.
I have never seen it.
No?
No. No, for that entry. That's awesome. I love it. Thank you very much.
I hope people like it. It's cool. I like the choke. See you next week, Brad.
Thanks, Deco. Appreciate it.